13 car buying mistakes you must avoid. When you make these blunders, you're toast. Hi, I'm Kevin Hunter, the Homework Guy, and author of Is That the Best You Can Do? It's your lucky day because you've arrived at the home of super high intensity training for car buyers. And today, we're doing a remake of one of the hottest videos we ever produced, titled 13 Car Buying Mistakes. As you can see, I'm joined by the amazing Elizabeth. Could you start by sharing any ideas you have on the original copy of 13 Car Buying Mistakes? Why do you think it did so well?
Well, Kevin, it's pretty simple. You are one of the first people to ever recognize the need to help car buyers. 13 Car Buying Mistakes was an instant hit because it touched so many different aspects of car buying. It gave consumers a ton of useful tools, and it made people think. That's exactly what we want our car wash to do, to think. Inform car buyers who think. Well, that's the kryptonite for car dealers.
We hope you're ready to take some notes because we're going to roll fast, and we're giving you tons of bonus material today, too, so buckle up. This is the question for our viewers. Are you kind of afraid to look at the paperwork from your last car deal because you're pretty sure that it was so bad? Or did you actually take a look at your car contract afterwards only to realize you severely screwed up? Well, today's video is going to help you avoid future humiliation.
This remake of 13 Car Buying Mistakes picks up some of the mistakes we covered years ago, brings it all up to date, and adds a bunch of gems into the mix. You must avoid these mistakes if you're going to get a good car deal.
Also, this video is just as much about what you should do as about what you shouldn't. So don't miss that. Every mistake will also have a corrective solution. Don't ignore this stuff or you could be toast.
Burnt toast. Mistake number one, you made an impulsive buy. Shoot, I don't even impulsively buy a candy bar.
No, she doesn't.
So for you car buyers, impulsiveness or desperation are your greatest enemies. It might surprise you to know that the best time to buy a vehicle is when you don't need one. There's no pressure, so you don't need the vehicle, and that alone gives you lots of leverage as a car buyer. You'll have no problem spending more time shopping around. You easily walk away from deals that aren't right for you because you have time and you're interested in not making mistakes.
Mistake number two, you went car shopping at a dealership before you did any serious research first. Never do this. Our car shopping mission always starts in front of a computer at home. Never start your research at a car dealership. Research your vehicle options online and then research market values too. Make sure you know what a vehicle is worth. For new cars, see our video on new car prices. And for used cars, see our video on used car prices.
Mistake number three, you didn't compare prices between dealers and pit them against each other. This is a big no-no. There are lots of ways to make sure you're getting a good price, but the best strategy is checking pricing at multiple dealerships. Everyone knows this or should.
Absolutely.
So take a look at our video on leverage. How do you get leverage for the dealer? By shopping prices at multiple dealerships, and this video explains exactly how to do it. So when you've done enough price shopping, you'll see a good car deal and you'll know it.
Mistake number four, you made an unplanned drive to a dealership. Bad move. Even when you've done your research, don't ever go to a car dealer on a whim. Do as much as you can online, trade emails back and forth with the dealership, talk to them on the phone, and when you're ready, set an appointment through the Dealer's Business Development Center, commonly known as the BDC, or with the Internet Manager. Before arriving at the dealership, you should have received photos of the vehicle you're interested in, both interior and exterior, and if it's a used car, ask for a video of it running. Get the vehicle history and a written price quote via email. When you get to the dealer, you'll know exactly who you're going to talk to. This greatly minimizes the game playing. If you encounter any red flags during this process, well, stop wasting your time. Move on to another dealer or seller.
Mistake number five, you didn't talk to your own bank or credit union first. Never put the fate of your car deal in the hands of people you don't know and you don't trust. A dealer finance officer is definitely someone who tops the don't trust list. So
exactly.
Shop that interest rate. Talk to your bank or credit union before you arrive at the dealership. Know what you qualify for. And if you decide to use that dealer financing, make them compete with what you already have. Also, make sure to ask about the rule of 78s. If the loan is set up that way, and make them put their answer in writing. In many states, a dealer uses their own bank. You open the door to the rule of 78s method, which front loads the loan with interest. So your initial payments are doing very little to bring down your loan balance.
We'll do a separate show on the rule of 78s because this is so important for you to understand. Rule of 78s is one of the number one reasons you should always use your own bank or credit union. Mistake number six. You didn't time your purchase. End of the month deals are always the best. Dealerships are motivated to sell cars year round, but given times of the month and later in the year, oh, that's when they get really hungry. You don't like to haggle? Well, nobody does. So time your purchase for the end of the month and aim for a Monday or Tuesday. If you want to time it even better, do the deal at the end of the year. They'll be the most patronizing dealer you've ever seen. Mistake number 7, you didn't negotiate.
Really? You didn't negotiate?
Nope. You thought the price was the price? The answer is always no unless you ask. So always ask. If the vehicle isn't properly priced, shoot the dealer an offer. Always negotiate and negotiate everything separately. Treat every part of the car deal as one part. The car you want to buy is one negotiation. The trade you have is another negotiation. The interest rate and loan term, well, that's another negotiation. Fees are a negotiation. Products are a negotiation. Accessories are a negotiation. Don't ever lump things together and don't ever fail to negotiate.
Mistake number 8, you didn't know that you could just say no. You'll have to say no often, so get used to it. There are also many ways you can say no, like being willing to leave the dealership.
Right.
Make sure you see our video on why you should walk. Getting up to walk is a hugely powerful form of saying no, and it gives you huge leverage. Have a lot of no's ready and always be willing to walk. Mistake number 9, you let them switch the car you were in. Really? We shouldn't even have to say this, but
no.
But you did just let someone else decide what car you're going to take home today. So maybe you were shopping online and saw a great deal, but when you called and showed up at the dealership, the car you wanted wasn't there. It didn't occur to you that this was just one way to bait you into the dealership. And now somehow you actually think that you need to work on this deal that they're making up on a completely different vehicle.
Don't do this.
You're so wrong. Vehicles are the second biggest lifetime purchase next to a house. Walk when this happens, get what you want, and don't ever let a dealer pull the car switch on you.
Mistake number 10, you focused on monthly payments. Oh my gosh. Did you know how big of a problem this is? Focus your entire conversation on the total cost and never on the monthly payment. When they extend your loan term, your monthly payment always looks lower, but are you really saving
any
money?
Not a bit. Nope.
You should know the answer to that question. If you are planning to pay 2.9%, for example, make sure that it's 2.9%. If you're planning on paying 36 months of payments, make sure your contract says 36 months, not 38 or 40 or 42. If you're planning to pay 48 months, make sure it pays 48 and so on. But if you're planning to pay 84 months, well, just shut this video off right now, throw all the caution in the wind, and go shop for a car and just ignore everything we've said so far. I'm kidding, you guys.
Yeah.
But seriously, don't ever finance a car for 72 or 84 months ever. And never negotiate on monthly payments.
Mistake number 11, you bought all the extras and paid all the fees. Aw, the extended warranty, the window, the VIN etching, the preferred package, fabric protection, paint protection, glass insurance, tire insurance, key fob insurance, and tons of fees. So you bought the story about protecting your investment, yikes, and you wound up buying the farm. Make sure you see our video on protecting your investment and understand why the strategy is so wrong.
Mistake number 12, you forgot to consider the total cost of ownership. This is a disaster. You were too busy thinking about the car prices, the features, the fees, and the products, and you forgot to think about getting a car insurance quote. You didn't check on the reliability of the vehicle you were buying, so you have no idea what your repair bills will be. You didn't know the vehicle you chose could cost so much to fix. You didn't know it got such terrible gas mileage, and your car made you car poor. Take all of this into consideration, because the extra cost, I've seen it where the extra cost of the car were just as much or more than the monthly car payment. Don't do this to yourself.
Mistake number 13, you sign the paperwork without reading it. Nobody should have to say that reading your contract later at home is the wrong time to read it.
Definitely the wrong time.
Comb through every paper with a fine-tooth comb and never sign something you don't completely understand. If you need to, phone a friend and read through everything with them. And if you talk to one of your friends in advance and let them know you're going to go car shopping and make call, then you don't have to worry about not being able to reach them.
Absolutely. Yes, you can make a ton more mistakes than the 13 mistakes we've shared today. And we may actually launch a part 2 of this video, perhaps taking a deeper dive into various aspects of the deal itself. Let us know if you want us to. But let me say this. If you avoid the mistakes that we pointed out today, all the bad luck that you seem to have car shopping, well, it's going to turn into good luck and a great deal on your next car purchase.
All right, if you appreciate this video today on the 13 car buying mistakes, give us that great big thumbs up, smash the subscribe button if you're not already subscribed, and of course, remember to ding that bell so you stay up to date on all of our latest stuff.
That's right. If you love what we do and want to send a tip, the PayPal and Cash App links that you see here on the screen, they'll be easy to find in that description box down below and on our website. But you know what's the best way that people can help us out?
Oh, help us get the word out. Share all these videos with your family and friends, and be sure to visit us on the other social media links you see appearing now on the screen. Wherever you like to hang out online, just join us and ask your friends to join us too. Let's get the homework guide to 1 million subs.
We're here for you, and we appreciate you being there for us. Thanks everyone for coming back. We'll see you on our next video. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter with the amazing Elizabeth.
We gotta go.